Today we are going to learn insertion of geometric mean between two numbers. Okay, so if suppose that two numbers are A and B, and if we have to insert single geometric mean between these two numbers, okay, so suppose G is the geometric mean between A and B, if and only if, or this A, G, B are in GP, then we can say that this G is called as a geometric mean of A and B. Okay, so if A, G and B are three numbers which are in GP, then this G is the geometric mean. Means here G square is equal to AB, or we can write G is equal to root AB. Okay, so if A, G, B are in GP, then G is called as a geometric mean of A and B, and this G we can write G square is equal to AB, or G is equal to root AB. Okay, so suppose if we have to find geometric mean between 4 and 9, okay. So if you have to find single geometric mean between 4 and 9, so suppose G is the geometric mean between 4 and 9, so G square is equal to 4 into 9, so G is equal to root 36, that is G is equal to 6, okay. So 6 is the geometric mean between 4 and 9, okay. So 6 is the geometric mean between 4 and 9. Similarly, if you have to insert geometric mean between minus 9 and minus 4, then G square is equal to minus 9 into minus 4, that is G is equal to root of minus 9 into minus 4. So that is G is equal to root 36, that is equal to minus 6. Okay, why we are taking minus 6 here? These two numbers are negative numbers, minus 9 and minus 4. Okay, so suppose two numbers are negative, then square root of product of that two number is a negative. Okay, means here if we simplify this, we can write like this, where root of minus 9 into root of minus 4. Now root of minus 9, we know that is a 3i, okay, complex number. Root of minus 4, that is a 2i, okay. Now if you simplify this, 3 2s are 6, and I into I square, okay. So I square is minus 1, so 6 into minus 1 is minus 6, okay. So if square root of minus 9 into minus 4 is there, geometric mean between minus 9 and minus 4 is a minus 6, okay. And if suppose one number is negative and another number is positive, okay, means opposite sign is there, then geometric mean does not exist, okay. So if two numbers are positive, that geometric mean take positive. If two numbers are negative, between that two numbers, geometric mean also is negative number, okay. So when condition is like this way, minus 9 and minus 4, so solve like this way, so geometric mean is a minus 6, okay. And if there is opposite sign, then geometric mean does not exist, okay. Now we will learn how to insert n geometric means between two numbers, okay. G1, G2 up to Gn are n geometric means between A and B then A G1 G2 to Gn and D are in GP. Okay, So if we have insert n geometric means between A and B, then we have to construct or we have to form A, G1, G2, Gn and B, that is in GP. Okay. So same like in AP, this GP contains n plus 2 terms because these are n terms. Okay, this is n plus means A, that is n plus 1 term, and this is n plus 2 term. Okay, so B, that is a n plus 2 term of GP. Okay, and R is a common ratio of GP. Okay, so n plus 2 term of GP, how we write? A into R plus 2. Now this is n plus 2 term, so n plus 2 minus 1. Okay, so that is A into R plus 2, n plus 1. Okay, so if we have to find R, I am shifting this A here. So B divided by A is equal to R plus 2, n plus 1. If we raise the power by 1 upon n plus 1, so we will get B by A raised to 1 upon n plus 1. So we will get R is equal to B upon A raised to 1 upon n plus 1. Okay. Now if we have to write geometric mean, that is G1 is equal to, now this is a second term, so that is A into R. Okay. This is first term, that is A, second term, that is AR, then third term is AR square, okay, G2 up to GN is equal to AR raised to N, okay. So, we can write this A into R value is B by A raised to 1 upon N plus 1, A into B by A raised to 2R square is there, so B upon A raised to 2 upon N plus 1. Okay, so similarly we will get N geometric means. Okay, so here if A and B is given, means first term and last term is given, first we have to find common ratio. Okay, how many geometric means we have to insert, that is N. Okay, so first we will find common ratio, then by using this formula we will get geometric means. Okay, so now we will see examples based on this geometric mean. First example is insert 5 geometric means between 576 and 9. Okay, so here B is equal to 9, A is equal to 576. Okay, then n is equal to 5. Okay, so first we have to find R. R is equal to B upon A raised to 1 upon n plus 1. So B, that is a 9, A is 576 raised to 1 upon 5 plus 1. So if we simplify this, it is divisible by 9. So 1 upon 9, 6 are 54, 3 remain 36, 9, 4 is a, so 1 upon 64 raised to 1 by 6. Okay. Now, if we find this, 64 is 6th power of 2. Okay. So, 2 raised to 6 is 64. So, 1 upon 2 raised to 6 raised to 1 by 6. So, we will get 1 by 2. Okay. So, R is equal to 1 by 2. Now, we have to find 5 geometric means. So G1 is equal to AR, that is A 576 into 1 by 2. So if we divide this, 2 2's are 4, 17, 2 8's are 16, 2 8's are 16. Okay, so G1 is equal to 288. Then G2 is equal to AR square, that is a 576 into R square, that is 1 by 2 square. So 576 into 1 by 4. So if we divide this, 4 1s are 4, 5 1s 4, 1 17, 4 4s are 16. Then 1 remaining 16, 4, 4, sir. Okay, so AR square is 144. Then G3 is equal to AR cube, that is the 576 into 1 by 2 cube. Okay, that is 576 into 1 by 8. So if we divide this 8, 7 is 56, 1 remaining 16, 8, 2 is okay. Then G4 is equal to AR raised to 4, that is 576 into 1 by 2 raised to 4. So 576 into 1 by 16. Okay. 2 raised to 4 is 16. So 16 3s are 48. 48, 57 minus 48, 9 remaining. Then 6. Okay, so G4 is 36 and then G5 is equal to AR raised to 5. So 576 into 1 by 2 raised to 5. So 576 into 1 by 2 raised to 5 is 32. So if we divide this, we will get 80. Okay, so 5 geometry means 288, 144, 72, 36 and 80. Okay, between 576 and 9. Okay, now we will learn some properties of geometric mean, then relation between or properties of arithmetic mean and geometric mean. Okay, here first property, that is if n geometric means are inserted between two quantities, then the product of n geometric means is the nth power of the single geometric mean between two quantities. Okay, so let us suppose that g1, g2 up to gn are n geometric means between two quantities, that is a and b. Here I am taking two quantities are a and b, and we have to insert g1, g2, gn, that is n geometric means between a and b. So if you have to insert n geometric means, so that is meaning of that a, g1, g2, gn, b are in gp. Okay, now what we have to show, that product of these g1, g2, gn is equal to nth power of single geometric mean between a and b. Okay, means we have to show that g1 into g2 into g3 up to gn is equal to, product of this is equal to g raised to n, single geometric mean between a and b. Okay, so how we show that? First, we know that r is equal to b upon a raised to 1 upon n plus 1. Okay, so g1, that is ar, g2 ar square up to gn is equal to ar raised to n. So if you have to take product g1 into g2 up to gn, that is ar into ar square into ar cube and so on, ar raised to n. Okay, now a into a n times, that is a raised to n. Okay, here r raised to 1, r raised to 2, r raised to 3. So if you multiply this, we will get r raised to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus up to n. Okay, because if you multiply, then we have to add the exponent. Okay, so a raised to n into r raised to, now 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus n, that is a sum of ap. These are natural numbers. Okay, now if you find sum of this, that is a n into n plus 1 divided by 2, n by 2 first term plus last term. Okay, so n by 2 n plus 1. Okay, now a raised to n, if we put value of r, that is a b by a raised to 1 upon n plus 1. So b by a raised to 1 upon n plus 1 and raised to this n by 2 into n plus 1. So this n plus 1 will cancel with this n plus 1. So what is remain? A raised to n b by a raised to n by 2. Okay. Now if we simplify this, okay, so if we simplify this, a raised to n b raised to n by 2, okay, this exponent I'm separating for numerator and denominator, so b by b raised to n by 2 upon a raised to n by 2. Okay, so if we take a raised to n by 2 in numerator, so a raised to n or a raised to n divided by a raised to n by 2, we will get a raised to n minus n by 2 into b raised to n by 2. Okay, now a raised to n minus n by 2, that is a raised to n by 2 into b raised to n by 2. Okay, now a raised to n by 2, so here we will get a raised to n by 2 into b raised to n by 2. Okay, so we can write like this way, a raised to 1 by 2 into b raised to 1 by 2 raised to n. Okay, so a raised to 1 by 2 means root a into root b raised to n, so we can write root a b raised to n. Okay, so if a and b are two quantities and if you have to insert one geometric or single geometric mean between a and b, then single geometric mean, that is a root a b, so g is equal to root a b, so instead of root a b we can put g, so g raised to n. So if we have to insert n geometric mean, then product of n geometric mean is equal to n power of the single geometric mean between a and b. Okay, here g is equal to root a b, that is a single geometric mean between a and b. Okay, now we will see properties of arithmetic mean and geometric mean. Okay, first property between arithmetic and geometric mean is if a and g are respectively arithmetic and geometric means between two positive numbers, okay, so this is important, between two positive numbers a and b, then a greater than g. Okay, so how we prove this? A is the arithmetic mean between a and b, so arithmetic mean, how we write? A plus b divided by 2. Okay, so a is the arithmetic mean between a and b, so a we can write a plus b upon 2. G is the geometric mean, that is the root of a b. Now if we show that a is greater than g, so we can show that a minus g greater than 0. Okay, if we show that a minus g greater than 0, okay, so this difference is positive, then we can say that a is greater than g. Okay, so if we find a minus g, a is a plus b divided by 2 minus g is root a b. So if we simplify this, a plus b minus 2 root a b upon 2. Okay, now if you observe this numerator, this is a square of root a minus root b. Okay, if we take square of this, we will get this term, a plus b minus 2 root a b divided by 2. So I am writing this 1 by 2. Okay, now you can see here root a minus root b square, okay, that is always positive. Okay, 1 by 2 is positive, so if this quantity is positive, means it is greater than 0. Okay, so if this is greater than 0, a minus g greater than 0. Okay, and if a minus g greater than 0 means a greater than g. Okay, so if a and g are arithmetic and geometric mean between two positive quantities, okay, so this a and b are positive numbers, so between a and g are between two positive quantities, then we can say that a greater than g. Okay, understand this one. Now we will take second property. Second property is if a and g are respectively arithmetic and geometric mean between two positive quantities a and b, then the quadratic equation having a and b as its roots. Okay, so if we have to write quadratic equation having a and b as the roots, then we can write that quadratic equation is x square minus 2ax plus g square. Okay, so how we write this? We know that a, that is arithmetic mean, so a plus b divided by 2, g, that is a root ab. Okay, so g square is equal to ab. Okay, now if we have to write equation whose roots are a and b, okay, so if we have to write quadratic equation whose roots are a and b, then how we write? Let a and b are roots of quadratic equation then that equation b, so if a and b are roots of quadratic equation, then that equation how we write? X square minus a plus b, that is the sum of the roots into x plus ab. Okay, now x square minus a plus b, this value from this how we write, that is a 2 into a, so a plus b we can replace by 2a into x plus ab, that is a g square, so is equal to 0. So x square minus 2ax plus g square is equal to 0, that is the quadratic equation whose roots are a and b. Okay, understand this one. Now we will take third property. Okay, property is if a and g are respectively arithmetic and geometric means between two positive numbers, then the numbers are a plus minus root of a square minus g square. Okay, means one number is a plus root of a square minus g square, second number is a minus root of a square minus g square. Okay, so if arithmetic mean and geometric mean between two numbers, positive numbers, is given, then we can find that two numbers by using this. Okay, now how we get this? We know that in second property we learn that quadratic equation is x square minus 2ax plus g square is equal to 0. Okay, then if we solve this by quadratic formula, so x is equal to minus b, that is minus of minus 2a, plus minus square root of b square, so 2a bracket square minus 4ac, so 4g square, divided by 2 into a, that is 1, so 2a plus minus square root of 4a square minus 4g square divided by 2. So if we simplify this, x is equal to, if we take 2, or if we take 4 outside the square root, so we get 2 in square root a square minus g square divided by 2. So if we take 2 common from all the terms and cancel with this 2, we will get x is equal to a plus minus root of a square minus g square. Okay, so one number we will get a plus root a square minus g square, and second number is a minus root of a square minus g square. Okay, so these are two numbers. Okay, if arithmetic and geometric mean is given, we can find two numbers by using this method. Okay, x is equal to a plus root of a square minus g square, and x is equal to a minus root of a square minus g square. Okay, so this is first number, this is second number. Okay, now we will take example based on these properties. Now we will take problems based upon arithmetic and geometric means. Okay, so first problem is find the value of n so that a raised to n plus 1 plus b raised to n plus 1 divided by a raised to n plus b raised to n may be the geometric mean between a and b. Okay, so if we suppose that g is the geometric mean between a and b, then value of g is equal to root ab, okay, or we can write a into b raised to 1 by 2, okay, or a raised to 1 by 2 into b raised to 1 by 2, okay. Now we have to find the value of n so that this is equal to geometric mean, means this is equal to a raised to 1 by 2 into b raised to 1 by 2. So if we take a raised to n plus 1 plus b raised to n plus 1 upon a raised to n plus b raised to n is equal to this, a raised to 1 by 2 into b raised to 1 by 2. Okay. Now if you multiply this here, so we will get a raised to n plus 1 plus b raised to n plus 1 is equal to, now a raised to 1 by 2 into b raised to 1 by 2, if we multiply to first term, here a raised to n is there, now a raised to n into a raised to 1 by 2, so if base is same, we have to add exponent, so we will get a raised to n plus 1 by 2 into b raised to 1 by 2, plus if we multiply this term to second term, a raised to 1 by 2 is as it is into b raised to n into b raised to 1 by 2, that is b raised to n plus 1 by 2, okay. Now I am shifting this term to LHS and this term b raised to n plus 1 towards to RHS, okay. So a raised to n plus 1 minus a raised to n plus 1 by 2 into b raised to 1 by 2 is equal to a raised to 1 by 2 into b raised to n plus 1 by 2 minus this b raised to n plus 1, okay. Now from this we can take a raised to n plus 1 by 2 common, okay, because this n plus 1, 1 we can write 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, so a raised to n plus 1 by 2 we can take common, so what is remain, a raised to 1 by 2 remain here, minus here b raised to 1 by 2 remain. Similarly from this we can take b raised to n plus 1 by 2 common, so here remain a raised to 1 by 2 minus b raised to 1 by 2, okay. From this a raised to n plus 1, how we take a raised to n plus 1 by 2 common, this we can write a raised to n plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, okay. So this we can write a raised to n plus 1 by 2 into a raised to 1 by 2, so if we take this common, a raised to 1 by 2 remain. Similarly for b raised to n plus 1, okay. Now this will get cancelled, okay. So what is the remain? A raised to n plus 1 by 2 is equal to b raised to n plus 1 by 2. Okay, if we divide here, a raised to, now here exponent is same, so we can write a divided by b raised to n plus 1 by 2 is equal to 1, okay. So a divided by b raised to n plus 1 by 2, this one we can write a divided by b raised to 0, okay, any number raised to 0 is 1. Now here base is same, so we can equate exponent, so n plus 1 by 2 is equal to 0, so value of n is minus 1 by 2, okay. So if value of n is minus 1 by 2, then this become geometric mean of a and b, okay. So if n is equal to minus 1 by 2, this value become geometric mean of a and b, okay. Now we will solve second example. Question is, find two numbers whose arithmetic mean is 34 and geometric mean is 16, okay. So here a is given 34 and g is given 16, okay. So if a and g is given, that two numbers we can find, that is a plus root of a square minus d square, that is the first number, and second number is a minus root of a square minus g square, okay. In third property we learn that if a and g is given, we can find that two numbers by using this, okay. Now if you put values, a is 34, so 34 plus 34 square minus 16 square. Okay, so 34 plus 34 square, that is 34 and 30. 136 plus 34 plus 12. So 1156 minus 16 square is 256. So 34 plus 6 minus 6 0 0 then 9. Okay, so 34 plus root 900, that is 30, that is a 64. Okay, and similarly second number is 34 minus 34 square minus 16 square. So 34 minus this answer is 30. So second number is 4. Okay. So that two numbers are 64 and 4. Okay. Arithmetic mean of these two numbers is 34 and geometric mean of these two numbers is 16. Okay. Now we will take third example. Third example is find two positive numbers whose difference is 12 and whose arithmetic mean exceeds the geometric mean by 2. Okay, so suppose two numbers are A and B. Let two numbers be A and B. Okay, so difference between two numbers is 12 given. So A minus B is equal to 12. This is equation 1. Okay. Second equation is given, arithmetic means exceeds the geometric mean by 2. Okay, means A minus G is equal to 2. So A is A plus B divided by 2. G is root AB is equal to 2. If you make same denominator, then A plus B minus 2 root AB divided by 2 is equal to 2. If you multiply this 2 here, we will get A plus B minus 2 root AB is equal to 4. Okay, now this is the perfect square of root A minus root B, bracket square is equal to 4. So if root A minus root B square is 4, that is the root A minus root B is equal to 2. Okay, now this is equation 2. So from 1, what we have, A minus B is equal to 12. Now A minus B we can write root A plus root B, and root A minus root B is equal to 12. Root A minus root B value is 2. So if we put 2 here, we get value of root A plus root B is equal to 12 divided by 2, that is a 6. Okay, this is equation 3. Now if we solve equation 2 and 3, we will get value of root A and root B. Okay, so if we add this, solving 2 and 3, root A is equal to, now if we add this, minus root B plus root B will get cancelled, 2 root A is equal to 8. So root A is equal to 4. So A is equal to 16. Okay, so root A 4, if we put here 4, so root B is 2, that is B is equal to 4. Okay, so A is 16, that is the first number is 16 and second number is 4, whose difference is 12 and arithmetic mean exceeds the geometric mean by 2. Okay, now we will take fourth example. Fourth example is, if A is the arithmetic mean of B and C and the two geometric means are G1 and G2, then prove that G1 cube plus G2 cube is equal to 2ABC. Okay, so A is the arithmetic mean of B and C, that is A is equal to B plus C upon 2. So we can write 2A is equal to B plus C. Okay, now G1 and G2, so let G1 and G2 are geometric means between B and C. Okay, So if G1 and G2 are geometric means between B and C means B, G1, G2, C are in GP. Okay. So we can find common ratio. So R is equal to last term, that is C, divided by first term raised to 1 upon n plus 1. N means how many geometric means we have to insert. So here we have insert 2 geometric means. So n is 2, that is 2 plus 1, 3. So we will get R is equal to C upon B raised to 1 by 3. Okay. Now we have to find G1. So G1 is equal to first term into R, that is the first term is B into R. So B into R value is C by B raised to 1 by 3. Now if we simplify this, B into C raised to 1 by 3 divided by B raised to 1 by 3. Okay. Now here B raised to 1 is there and here B raised to 1 by 3. So if we simplify this, B raised to 1 minus 1 by 3, that is the B raised to 2 by 3 into C raised to 1 by 3. Okay. So this is value of G1. Now G2 is equal to B R square. So B into value of R is C by B raised to 1 by 3. But again raised to 2 is there. That is a 2 by 3. So B into C raised to 2 by 3 upon B raised to 2 by 3. So here B raised to 1 is there. If we simplify this, 1 minus 2 by 3, that is a 1 by 3. So B raised to 1 by 3 into C raised to 2 by 3. Okay. Now we have value of G1 and G2. So if we find G1 cube plus G2 cube, that is equal to G1 cube, that is a B raised to 2 by 3 into C raised to 1 by 3 bracket cube plus G2 cube is B raised to 1 by 3 into C raised to 2 by 3 bracket cube. Okay. So if we take this 3 to both numbers, okay, B and C, so we will get here B square into C plus here B into C square. Now if we take B into C common, what is remain? B plus C, and B plus C, we know that is equal to 2A. So B C into this 2A. From 1, if we give here 1, so we can write here from 1. Okay, so we will get value of G1 cube plus G2 cube is 2ABC. Okay, understand this one. Now in next video we will start a new topic, that is a trigonometry. Okay.